schon kräftig begonnen. Ich freue mich ein zweites Mal, die Paralympics 1995 in Duderstadt eröffnen zu können. Bravo.
For Rita Susanuk, serving as chief patron of the second Paralympics revival was an honor. Almost 100 athletes from all five continents provided suspenseful competition at the highest level. Al Mead, not your everyday visitor. This spokesman for the U.S. athletic team will sing the Paralympics anthem in Atlanta. In the broad jump, he plays second behind Swiss champion Lucas Christen, who holds the world record with a leap of 5.26 meters. Preparations for the final heat of the 100-meter sprint for above-knee amputees.
Ab geht die Bus, 100 Meter. Auf Bahn 3, Lukas Christen, der vor noch schnellste auf der Kontaktbahn. Lukas Christen auf Bahn 3, vor Kontaktbahn. Lukas Christen vor Kontaktbahn.
Lucas Christen wins almost as decisively as in last year's World Championships. His initial reaction reveals some disappointment directed at the stop clock.
Ja, siehst du, das, dieses Jahr ist ein Zwischenjahr und da schaust du immer so, ja, wie bist du drin? Keine Wettkampferfahrung. Dann schaust du mal, oder? Kein Wind, 13,80.
12/100ths of 1 second slower than the world record, but this Swiss athlete is hardly ever satisfied with himself. Jörg Schiedeck, best German in a world-class field of participants, finished second in his event. In spite of poor health, China's Sun Chang Ting, world record holder in the javelin, traveled halfway around the world just to be in Duderstadt. Participation is everything. Just to participate also means a great deal on this day to Jörg Frischmann. Inspired by the competition, he achieves a new personal best with almost 48 meters. Ludovico Halagahu from France doesn't even give his rivals a chance. His javelin lands well beyond the 50-meter mark. When Canadian Bob Wade is called to the measuring tape, it becomes clear that this world champion has also set a world record. Even in the preliminaries, it was clear that a world record would be broken in the women's broad jump. A below-knee amputee athlete had unofficially broken the world record in her class 4 times, only 1 week prior to the revival. At the World Championship competitions in Berlin, Austrian Andrea Czerny made the roster of world record holders. After setting the world record in broad jump, Czerny was assured a place on the winner's block for the 100 meter. The Austrian doesn't know it at this moment, but she is about to set a fantastic world record. For the first time, a Bologna amputee woman passes the finish line at under 15 seconds. Two world records. Czerny couldn't possibly have given herself a better present on her 29th birthday.
Das können wir schon gut. Letztes Jahr haben wir geübt. Mal da raus.
Aber das ist natürlich überhaupt ein schönes Zielfoto mit der Zeit. Danke dir, gell? Eigentlich der Weltrekord über 100 Meter überrascht mich total. Und vor allem die Zeit. Also ich war schon in der Nähe, so um ein Zehntel schlechter, aber dass es eine 14er Zeit wurde, war mir eigentlich nicht bewusst vorher.
The discus events in the open class are hot. During the preliminary rounds, some of the above-knee amputees have already been eliminated. This time, German athlete Horst Beyer was hit, and it wasn't the system causing him problems, but rather his own throwing technique. To stay on the top internationally and to defend his gold medal, he changed to a rotating technique. Beyer didn't want to give up open competitions. After Sean Brown throws his discus, Canadian Bob Wade is called by the officials for a fourth time. 50.86 meters, a new world record. Some amputees qualify for Atlanta in Duderstadt while 3,000 live spectators watch. At this moment, the revival makes sports history. For the first time, all Bologna amputee participants in the finals crossed the 100 meter finish line in under 13 seconds. In his fastest race, Neil Fuller doesn't even require 12 seconds.
Das war der Startschuss für die 5000 Meter der Männer. Im Ziel noch 12 Runden zu laufen.
Guy with a volley.
Not too fast, Paul. Stay there.
Fast Angst ist halt. Der Engländer läuft ein großartiges Rennen.
Konsequent bleibt er dran. Ganz konsequent bleibt er dran.
Spain's Javier Conde, acting world champion and Paralympics champion in Barcelona, is still in second place. Through the last curve, he gains the lead, rejoicing as he crosses the finish line. One of the traditional highlights at track and field events, the high jump. Like most above-knee amputees, German Detlef Eckert jumps head first. Bologna amputees have adopted the flop technique.
Die sind gerade.
Florian Bull achieves the only victory for Germany at the second Paralympics revival with a jump of 1.83 meters. However, three Germans place behind him. From an athletic viewpoint, the shot put is the closing highlight of the Paralympics revival. In spite of his setting a new world record with the discus only a short time before, Sean Brown is clearly disappointed, having placed sixth in the shot put. But his standards are especially high since he trains with able-bodied athletes who are preparing for the Olympics. A new world record was already in the cards for Jerzy Dąbrowski. Then the Polish athlete gave even a little more, to be exact, almost 30 centimeters more, breaking his own world record that he had just set, with a throw of 14.61 meters. Following its 1993 premiere in Göttingen, Germany, the Paralympic revival have found a permanent home in Duderstadt. The Autobahn Group of Companies has pledged its continuing support of this event. And as Rita Süssmuth said 2 years ago, a first time requires a second time, and after the second time, there is a trend. Goodbye, au revoir, and Peter Zane in Duderstadt in 1997.